not the other one, hall K. Sorry, I don't think the presentation is here. It's been loaded in the preview, and I don't think he's sure of what he's doing. So you might want to go ahead, and then I can always come back in. I don't want to use the timer.
We invite Dr. Rashmi Gupta to present her study on the collaborative Indian study on eyelid malignancies. Can you load Dr. Rashmi Gupta's paper, please? Can we have the lights dimmed?
To start?
Yes.
Timing is showing 3.
We'll give you 3 extra seconds, Roshi.
Okay. Good morning. We know from literature that Western population shows a predominance of basal cell carcinoma. When we look at the Asian literature, whether from Iran or Pakistan, or Singapore, or the Chinese in Hong Kong, basal cell carcinoma is still predominant at varying degrees. The study from Japan, though, shows equal numbers of sebaceous carcinoma and basal cell carcinoma. How about India? There are just 3 studies with adequate numbers, and one of them is from a surgical oncology center, 2 of which show predominance of basal cell carcinoma, and 1 shows equal numbers of SGC, BCC, and sebaceous carcinoma. So we decided it's time we know some pan-Indian representative data on eyelid malignancy. We got together combined multicenter data from 3 geographic zones in India, from subspecialty single-person practices following similar practice patterns and documentation and following similar management protocols. And we used a common data collection format. We did a retrospective analysis of clinical features, pathology, AGCC classification, travel distance, and treatment and outcome. Now, travel distance for a patient from within the city was taken as 0. All outstation addresses were noted in kilometers. We ended up with 108 eyes of biopsy-proven eyelid malignancy with equal numbers of women and men, with a mean age of 64 years. 17% of the patients had had previous incisional biopsy or excision without edge clearance, and the mean interval to consultation was 18 months. The lesions included basal cell carcinoma, sebaceous carcinoma, and the rarer things such as squamous cell carcinoma and sweat gland carcinoma. Vying for the top spot in frequency was sebaceous carcinoma at 42%, and basal cell carcinoma at 39%. All others together made up about 18%. Clinically and statistically, there's no difference between these numbers, sebaceous carcinoma and basal cell carcinoma. Pagetoid spread was seen in 28% of sebaceous carcinoma. Orbital extension was seen in 9% of all these tumors. When we looked at the AGCC grading, a combined T2B and T3A comprised 70% of the tumors, and we'll come to the significance of that later. 90% of the patients underwent surgical correction with surgery with margin clearance, either excision biopsy or orbital excentration. 14 out of 108 underwent PET CT, all were negative, and no sentinel node biopsy was done. The average follow-up was 9.9 months. 6 patients showed metastasis or recurrence, all of them sebaceous or squamous cell carcinoma. Recurrence was seen in 9% of sebaceous carcinoma within even this short follow-up period, and parotid node mets in 1 sebaceous carcinoma. Interestingly, even though the metro patients made it to the consultation earlier than the outstation patients, if you look at the follow-up, it's equal whether the patients were from in-station or out-station, and they had to travel an average distance of 134 kilometers. So to summarize, what we knew earlier was that data from across the globe show varying frequency of different eyelid malignancies. Data from India, which were all single-center studies, showed variations. And at any forum, you'll have the popular perception that sebaceous carcinoma is the commonest eyelid malignancy in India. So current study is a representative multi-center, multi-zonal report with similar assessment methods and similar treatment protocols between the co-authors. This eliminates a referral bias. A 134-kilometer distance means the patients are from that locality. And this has an AJCC classification as well. So what we learn from here is sebaceous carcinoma and basal cell carcinoma are equally prevalent in India. Majority of patients, that is 70%, are either T2B or T3A by AJCC classification, well within surgically resectable stage. So preserving eye and vision, which is good news for us all. In spite of appropriate protocol-based surgery, including margin clearance, sebaceous carcinoma shows mets or recurrence in 10% of patients within 10 months. But stringent follow-up needs to be reinforced. And patients are willing to travel and follow up to more than 100 kilometers for specialty treatment. So this is an information we can use for future resource management. Thank you.
You said 10% of patients had recurrence. So did you do anything to address that? I mean, how did you follow those patients?
10% of patients among sebaceous carcinoma had recurrence.
Yeah.
Okay, so our standard protocol, which we all follow, is post-op follow-up is at 1 week, 6 weeks, and then 3 monthly for a year, and then 6 monthly onwards. So the because once it goes into the node metastasis, it goes into neck dissection and so on. Local recurrence, it's usually known that 25 to 40% end up with loco-regional recurrence. So most of these patients had to either undergo re-resection or orbital excentration.
And did you find that they were more aggressive when they recurred, or was there any difference in the clinical presentation at that point?
If you could, you mean the difference in clinical presentation right at the beginning?
And when the patient came back to you?
When the patient came back to us, usually the progress was more rapid than at the first presentation. A recurrent tumor progressed more rapidly. The change in size was more rapid.
Dr. Roshmi, what was the dropout rate in all the three centers?
Okay, when we advised surgery in the first place, dropout was 10%. 90% underwent treatment. Post-treatment, when we followed up, 35% did not follow up more than 6 months. 65% had longer follow-up. They kept coming back for reviews.
And second question is, majority of your patients are locally advanced or advanced stage. Have you tried neoadjuvant chemotherapy also or not? Only surgical?
Not in this set of patients, because ultimately, you know, neoadjuvant chemotherapy, if you, of course, you would be agreeing that it's a process of downstaging a tumor. We are not ultimately going to change the treatment. It is going, if it's going in for excentration, it's ultimately going in for excentration. We can only manage an eyelid sparing.
Sebaceous gland carcinoma will respond to the chemotherapy.
Okay, sebaceous carcinoma.
Most of your patients are in advanced.
Sebaceous carcinoma, neoadjuvant chemotherapy, although it raises a lot of interest, when we actually look at the published literature, it is not that encouraging. Ultimately, because we have nothing else, sebaceous carcinoma doesn't respond well to radiation. It keeps recurring. So yes, it's a promising thing, but it is not yet the standard of care.
No. Actually, what happened? There is a debulking in advanced stage, particularly the sebaceous gland carcinoma having intraepithelial spread, pegetoid spread, that helps in your outcome as well as surgical tissue loss and correction also.
Thank you.
I just have a small, was the pathology uniform at all the three centers? Did you have a common pathologist?
That is the problem with this the study, that we don't have a common pathologist, and that is why we haven't even attempted a pathological classification. Our classification is clinical alone. Thanks.